really windy day. It's a dirt pitch. Conditions are going to be tricky for everybody.
Despite being one of the most popular spectator sports in the land, Chinese football is suffering.
The men's national team has had a dreadful showing over the past few decades, and the football-playing population remains very small. But despite its problems, football in China is on the rise, due mainly to small leagues run by the people that are popping up around the country.
We're headed out to Huilingguang. It's a working-class suburb of Beijing, and we're going to meet up with a bunch of guys there who formed one of the oldest and most famous grassroots football leagues in all of China, the Huilingguang Super League.
现在有业余的足球队应该有五六十支。快点，兄弟！我们是要做一些情感的足球的基础的普及，它是中国足球腾起绝非一天的一个最好的根基。跟大家说个事儿啊，就是我们在年前呢接到丽江当地的一支这个业余球队的邀请。 希望我们在年后呢过去跟他们有个交流啊，比赛呢其实不是很重要，重要去跟他们这群朋友认识交流啊玩。不论去了，咱们在球场任何问题都有几种出面。行了，我们说完了。
How's your English?
English a little. A little. Speak Chinese, okay?
Yeah, speak Chinese.
Although it's something you might take for granted in other football-playing nations, a team from the bustling metropolis of Beijing taking a trip to play a team from rural China is something that just doesn't happen here.
It's a rare traveling friendly match in China. We're heading to Lijiang. It's gonna be great.
Where
are we going?
I don't know.
Can you tell me a little about the history of the town here?
我们这个村是算得上算是丽江的这个古村落了，纳西族的文传统文化来讲也有一千多年的历史。农民嘛，也是种地为主，种地啊收了时候起早贪黑。我们这个村剃球已经几十年的历史，主要是有球剃啊，就把手里的活放下跟着锯。这个场地10年才开始建的。 也没有想到你会有这么好的一个对手会过来。
game day here in Lijiang, we're headed back to the village of Yuhu in the mountains. City boys here are quietly confident, but I think the mountain boys are going to give them a run for their money.
Lijiang. Lijiang.
Jiang.
Perfect.
Perfect.
今天是个好天气, 只要没有风, 就好了。
喂, 今天四点钟起啊, 北京啊,
这天的话呢，二个渔户去了，有一比三不见，自己的家吃不见。我们来这里的最主要的目的是为了来跟云南的同胞交流足球文化，场地、风景啊、天气、气候都不是问题。
这个场地最重要的就是不能跌倒，随便一倒就会破皮啊。主场优势也就是这个，你看自然条件嘛。这么一个环境，这么一群热爱足球人在坚持，很不容易。Beijing are in white and blue, Yuhu are in red, and the whole village has come out to watch the game. It was a fast game, notable for the wind, the dirt, and the sheer number of goals scored. The City boys went up 7 before conceding a single goal themselves. But in the second half, the locals fought back, scoring 3 fine goals in a row. A barrage of goals from both sides followed, but the Beijing guys kept the pressure on. And victory went to Wang Yuyu and his team, making for an entertaining match and a final score of 13-7.
So the team from Beijing played the team from Yuhu today. It was a great game, hard fought. I think it ended 13-7, but what's most important is everyone's getting together, having a meal, having a good time.
业余足球的作用不在于它的经济水平有多高，它会带动我们的下一代、下下一代持续的喜欢足球。因为中国足球现状呢，确实在一个相对来说低水平的一个阶段，它可能要通过很多人的努力。中国足球应该说现在不是走进步，是已经重新高了嘛？早晚肯定能够走出亚洲，甚至走向世界高峰去。这是我们中国队的心愿嘛？